order, can I welcome everybody to this meeting of the Cabinet? Just need to give George Davies' apologies if they could be recorded. So we'll go into the agenda. Item one is members' code of conduct. Do any members of the Cabinet wish to declare any interests? No? Okay, thank you. Item two are the minutes of the last meeting. Can we agree that I signed was a true record? Is that agreed? Okay, so that takes us on to item three, the leaders' update, executive key decisions taken under delegated powers, and there's just one referred to there, which is the decision by Cabinet Member Public Health. Can we note that decision? Okay, thank you. Okay, item four, rural plan. This is a rural plan progress update 2016-17, quarter one. I'll ask Ann McLachlan to introduce this, please, Ann.
Thanks, Bill. This is a report of Cabinet. This is the quarter one report, April to June 2016 this year, and it's not, the report provides an opportunity for Cabinet to be updated on progress towards achieving our 20 pledges and delivery of the rural plan. I think it's important to point out there's a lot more detailed performance data presented quarterly to the overview and scrutiny committees, and also is monitored by the Rural Partnership Delivery Group. But it's a progressing and improving picture, and I think I'd just like to point out a few highlights from the report, if I may, Phil. And the first one, in terms of our pledge towards, you know, providing homes across the borough, just in this past year, 1,250 empty properties have been brought back into use. 400 homes of the 400 of those have been approved, and about 760 of them have been updated to help vulnerable people live their lives more independently. So that coupled with our ambitions on building homes is a very good start towards